Hi, I'm Jeannie Lynn. Most people know me by JL. I've been attending the Rolling Meadows campus since 2000. I came to know Jesus as a young teenager. I longed and desired to go to either Hope College or Central College in Pella, Iowa. But because there was no money where I grew up and my family, I couldn't do that. So I just was determined to have a career. And that's what I did for 33 years. I just stayed in, I was in the insurance industry, stayed in that career for 33 years and dreamed about retiring at 65 and working for my church and doing whatever job they might want. And that was a dream I had as a teenager, and I kept that dream my entire life, just wanting to work for God when I retired. I became unemployed for the third time in the insurance industry in 2003. And every insurance job, the door just kept closing and closing. And a gentleman that had worked for me years ago convinced me I should go in business with him. It was risky because I was going to have to use all of my retirement money, which I had coveted for years. I had to ask myself that question: do I trust God with my retirement, or do I trust me? I gave up the money, and I had to literally use all that money to keep this business going in the beginning. At that time, I was involved in the divorce recovery group at Harvest, and I was approached, could we put the food pantry over there? And it dawned on me, donating space for the food pantry, that's working for God. Maybe not in the way I dreamed about it for 40 years, but I was working for God here. You know, I give out literature a lot. I mean, every year, Christmas and Easter, I would give out literature to my customers, and we got some pretty nasty people who canceled because we give out literature for Christ. But I just would smile, and it never discouraged me because I just was convinced this was where God put me to work for Him. I was diagnosed with stage 2 rectal cancer. And then with the last test, it was stage 4. And it was a pretty strong pill to swallow. And I told my staff, they walked through this whole thing with me, and I said, okay guys, Jesus does not lie and He does not break His promises. And I said, this is a really hard road He's asked me to walk down. But I believe that God doesn't lie. I came in early the next morning, and I think I put 6 or 7 things on the whiteboard because I wanted to show them how to pray. So first we're gonna pray, thank you, Jesus. And I said, the next thing we're gonna tell God is, may many people find salvation. I can't have cancer for You not to be glorified in it. So may many people find salvation because of my cancer. Then we're gonna pray for God to annihilate the cancer. And I said, annihilate it so that everybody's wondering what happened to it. And the only possible way that it could have gone away is through a miracle, a modern day miracle from Jesus. There were at least 7 or 8 things I taught my staff how to pray for, gave it to friends, and everybody had this list of things. And at the end of 6 of the 12 treatments, I was measured. And I didn't cry when I was told I had cancer. But at the end of the measurement after that 6th treatment, I was cancer free. It was a miracle. God annihilated my cancer exactly how I asked Him to. And I cried profusely that day and for the next couple of days that God would give me the privilege of having cancer to work for Him, just like I dreamed about my whole life. And that He would give me this miracle to continue to work for Him. I mean, when your heart's aligned with God, there are no coincidences, and you realize that we are witnesses, and the most powerful witnesses, unfortunately, have to walk through difficulties like I have and like you have and like others will. So I faithfully enjoyed having the food pantry here. I continue to faithfully give out literature and Bibles. I'm in charge of being faithful, just like you're in charge of being faithful. but please never think you're in charge of results. That's God's job.